Snapchat unveiling new augmented reality glasses, and GM electric cars can now use Tesla chargers.
This guy, Rich DeMuro, explains in today's Rich on Tech and the continued expansion of the Tesla charger, which is known to be faster than the other chargers. My understanding, anyway. That's a big deal.
Yeah, it's a big deal because if you have one of these cars, it's like you got a new way to charge it, which is great. More options. We'll get to that in a moment. But first, let's start with this. LinkedIn using its users' data to train its AI models, but there is a way to turn it off. The website 404 Media found that LinkedIn quietly started using its users' data to train its AI. This means it can teach its generative AI systems how to create new content based on your posts, your uploads, and even maybe your profile pictures. Problem is, the setting is turned on by default, and LinkedIn did not update their terms of service or even inform users before enabling it. Now, if you don't want this, you can go into LinkedIn settings under data and privacy and turn off the switch that says, use my data for training content creation AI models. Charging on the go just got a little bit easier for GM electric car owners. That's because they can now tap into Tesla's supercharging network. GM released an adapter that lets users charge at Tesla stations. The adapter is $225. It can be purchased through GM's mobile apps. Once you have it, you're able to charge at over 17,000 Tesla superchargers across the nation. As you might know, nearly every major car manufacturer has adopted Tesla's charging connection as the standard, but most new cars won't have the redesigned ports until the next year or two. Ford is giving away their adapter for free, but you only have until September 30th to claim it. And finally, Snap has unveiled a new version of their augmented reality glasses. The social media app held their partner summit earlier this week in Santa Monica. I was there to check it out and try on the new spectacles, as they're called. They look like an oversized pair of sunglasses, but they have tiny see-through screens in the lenses. This lets you see pictures and videos overlaid on your real-world surroundings. The glasses have cameras, microphones, and speakers built in, but the tech is still bulky and the image quality is still basic, but it gets the job done. I'm going to share my full experience with spectacles in an upcoming report. All right, if you want more information on anything I mentioned, including how to turn off that LinkedIn switch, I've got it on the website, richontech.tv.
Wonderful, Rich. Thank you, as always.